All right, now, can art therapy used as a tool to recover from past trauma? In this next report, we take a look at the story of these sexual assault survivors who've turned therapy through art to help other women survivors. Take a look.
Cousins Ellie Clogarty and Kristen Malinowski grew up in Northern Virginia and both headed to Virginia Tech to get a degree in neurobiology. The young women had a lot in common. One of the big things, both say they are survivors of campus sexual assault. As part of their recovery, the two launched a jewelry line called Camaria.
When I started designing jewelry, I went from an idea of something that wasn't in existence yet, and you could just find a way to bring it to life.
The young women started studying jewelry making in New York and traveled the world to learn different jewelry styles. A year after Camaria was launched, Clogarty and Malinowski started a nonprofit called Restore Dignity that offers financial help to the victims of campus sexual assault. 10% of Camaria's proceeds go to the Restore Dignity.
You would be surprised to know that we have had applications from students who are having their diplomas held until they pay their student health care costs, and those student health care costs were directly attributed to sexual assault.
Many jewelry pieces that Clogarty and Malinowski make are asymmetrical. The cousins say they are meant to show beauty in imperfection.
It's so meaningful, and it's easy to attach symbology to something so small.
One of our signature pieces is the butterfly necklace, and the butterfly represents hope and transformation, which is a good reminder for survivors.
The young women believe the COVID pandemic has taught people to be more empathetic towards each other. They say these times are forcing many people to lead very isolated lives, like the ones sexual assault victims often lead.
Camaria means moonlight in Swahili, so the idea is, like the moon, even when you're surrounded by darkness, you reflect light just because you exist.
Maxim Moskalko for VOA News, Washington.